वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम राकेश गंगरेजा फ्रॉम रायपुर खालसा कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग। द नेम ऑफ सब्जेक्ट इज PPS एंड द सब्जेक्ट कोड इज BTPS 10118। सो वी आर ऑलमोस्ट डन विद आवर सिलेबस। इनफैक्ट वी आर फिनिश्ड विद आवर सिलेबस विद बोथ थ्योरी एंड प्रैक्टिकल्स। वी हैव फिनिश्ड ऑल द एस्पेक्ट्स एंड नाउ वी आर मूविंग टुवर्ड्स सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस। What are the expected questions and what are the various things which we always keep in mind while we are studying C. Okay, so before discussing about those questions, I would like to discuss that just whenever you are going for exam, one thing you should keep in mind that each and everything we have already finished in our classroom and video lectures. The only thing is that keep yourself relaxed and keep your nerve handy in order to fetch the maximum output from your exam. There are certain questions which are analytical or maybe certain set of programs in which we need to think something in order to find out the exact output. You are not supposed to hesitate. You're not supposed to be nervous. Just be relaxed and focus on the program and you will achieve it. Okay guys, so the first important thing which we are discussing in this particular video, so we are discussing important question, is the data types. As there is hardly any single program we have done in the PPS whole course that we have not used the data types. Every variable in the C is associated data type. Every data type requires different amount of memory. We have already discussed about that thing. And this is a short sample video in which we will only discuss what do you mean by data types, why it is important, and what are the things which we need to learn in order to attempt the question if we are having the question data types in C. Hopefully in many of the cases the data type will come in 10 mark, data type is a 10 marks question. Okay, so every variable is associated with the data type. Every data type requires different amounts of memory, some specific operations which can be performed over it. The basic data types are they are shown over there: char, int, float, double. Okay, different data types also have the different range up to which they can store number. The range of the data type that we have discussed vary from compiler to compiler, 32-bit, 64-bit. As in the certain starting videos that we have, starting video lectures, we have also discussed about the range of compiler, and we have discussed how if we have the value of the integer is this and we are expecting a compiler to be of that bit. Okay, keeping in mind that particular thing, we'll focus on these things. We are also having the range of integers. We can say short int, unsigned short int, integer, long int, signed char, unsigned char, float, double, long double. We have discussed about the memory, how much memory they will take, what is the range of that particular integer, what are the format specifier. I'll just repeat that stuff. For float, the format specifier is we'll use F for that. For double, we use LF. Okay, for long double, we use capital LF. For signed char, we'll use C. For integer, we'll use D. For unsigned int, we'll use U. Short int, we'll use HD. All those things will come under the programs, and we have discussed all those things in while we were discussing about the data types in the classroom lectures. Okay, so the char is a basic data types. Okay, it will store a single character. Okay, and the size of signed char or unsigned char is 1. Integer, as the name suggests, it contains the integer value. If you remember, in many of the program we have used int main. So whenever we have used int over there, it will definitely return a integer value. And the size of integer, for some cases we can short int, we can go for 2, although it is vary from the size of compiler to compiler. For unsigned short int 2, for signed integer 4, for integer 4, for long int 8, unassigned long int which is 8 bytes. Okay, and the range, you remember, the short end is -3 to 7 6 8 to 3 to 7 6 7. we know what is that range, how the value comes between that particular range, what happened if we assigned a value out of the range. All those things we have discussed in deep while we were discussing in the theory lecture. We have also implemented that particular program if we come out from the range in the lab. Float, it is used to store a decimal number. Okay, the size is 4, format is per F, double 8, long double 16. Okay, the things are clear from that. And then we have double, and the size is, and the format size is 16, and the format specifier is capital LF. Okay, so this is a very basic step, basic thing. Although we have also having the other data types, which is int, array, pointers, okay, in we have discussed about all those things. Pointer, we have finished all those video, all those theory lectures. For pointer, we have done the video lectures. For structures, we have done the video lecture. For union, we have done the video lecture. All those things you can study from that. At this time, in this particular video, we only just touch that concept 10 to 20% in order to let you know that what we have studied. I'll just initializing the process of recalling, and then you just need to complete that recalling process to the completion process by looking towards the notes or from the or from book or from any other source which we have done. Okay, I hope this is clear from that this point of view right now. Next, we have discussed about the iteration statements. If you remember, it's called as the loops. Iteration treatments were in some books and some formats, or we have also studied that iteration statements creates a loops in the program. It repeats a sets of statements until the condition is met. Okay, so we are discussing about for, do, while. We have already discussed about all those things. If you remember, all those things have been discussed in the precise way, in the deeper way, while we were discussing in the lab or in the lecture. Okay, so let's discuss. So loop statements need to be written once, okay, and it will be executed as many times that we want to execute. Okay, there are many sequence and many instructions which can be executed by using the loop statements. Okay, only thing which we need to remember is the counter. Okay, if the counter has not reached the desired number, the next instructions in the sequence return to the first instruction. Okay, when the counter has been reached, okay, next instructions directly falls through to the next sequential instruction. Okay, so while we were discussing about the loops, we'll discuss about the three types of things. One is initialization expression, next is test expression or update expression. Okay, so we have discussed, we have implemented, we have viewed all those things. I'm repeating again and again. Now I'm just touching that concept that this is something which we have learned, and this is something what we need to do. Okay, in initialization part, we just need to initialize. Guys, you're supposed to say with me, okay, we have to initialize loop. Yes, you are thinking right. We have to initialize loop counter to some values. For example, we have initialized for I is equal to 1, for integer I is equal to 1. We have initialized a loop to 1. Okay, now next condition comes the text expression. What we are going to do in the text expression. In this expression, we have to test the condition, and if the condition evaluates to true, then we'll execute the body of the loop, okay, and then go to the next part, which is called as the update expression. If now definitely there is a condition when we'll say whether it comes true or whether it comes false. If it comes true, we'll go inside the body of loop. It comes false, we'll exit from the loop. For example, if we have condition for I less than equal to 10 and the value of the I is 20. So 20 is not less than 10. So we'll come out from the loop. Next, we have update expression. After executing the loop body, the expression increment or decrement. This can also be called as increment or decrement. by using some value. For example, I plus 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 I, I minus 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 I, first and pre increment. Okay. Now, while studying for loop, we have seen that the number of iteration is known beforehand. We know how many number of iteration, number of times the loop bodies need to be executed known to us. And the while loop is used in a situation when we don't know the exact number of iteration. We don't know how many times the loop is going to be executed. Okay, at that time we'll use while loop. Okay, when the loop condition, loop execution is terminated on the basis of test condition. Then moving forward towards while loop. While loop is basically exit control loop. In this type, what happened? The condition is tested or evaluated at the end of the loop body. What does it mean? It means the loop will definitely go for once, at least once, irrespective of what is going to be the test condition. Loop is going to be work. But in case of entry control loop like for and while, the test condition is very much necessary. You need to make your test condition true in order if you want to go to the next part. Okay, so this is the second important topic, loops in C. Next we have switch statement. This is a very common question. Definitely it is going to be helpful for when you are moving forward to the next semesters, or if you are keeping the university exam perspective. A very common, very important concept. Okay, so what is basically C? Let's discuss first. For example, we have if else statement. Okay, the same thing which we have discussed, I'll use the same methodology, same example. If else in C allows you to choose between true and false when there are two or more options. We use nested if. So what if we have the 10 alternative to choose? What we'll do? Okay, if we use nested if in this situation, the logic is difficult to understand, and else if statement and if statement can handle such time of things effectively. Okay, so we'll explore switch statement over there. Almost to switch is having the same function as else if condition. Switch may have many number of cases. It compares the expression value with the value which is assigned to the case. If the both value matches, then that particular case is going to be work. And when we want to come out from that particular case, we'll use break statement. Okay. It also allows us to add default statement if a variable which is not equal to that particular case. The case when we discuss in the class, when right hand side is not equal to left hand side, then the last part of the switch statement is going to execute, which is the default statement. Okay, and the break is definitely be useful to come out from the switch statement. Otherwise, all the statement in the switch case will execute it. Whenever break statement encountered, the execution would directly come out from the switch. Okay, this is what we have discussed when we were discussing about the switch statement. Okay. So now you are at such a point that I should not able to explain the switch statement program to you. I should not able to explain that particular syntax which is in front of your screen. That what is an expression, what is a case constant 1, what is case constant 2, and how default is going to be work. All these things, repeating the same thing, discussed, implemented in both theory as well as in the lab. Okay, so you should just go now that you got the information that the switch is important. You should just discuss about the important parameters related to switch, like what are the various conditions, what we can do in switch, what we cannot do in the switch. If you remember, we have done a program in which we just when a person type capital letter or small letter, whether the switch is different or same. We have discussed about all those programs. Given you certain condition, you have evaluated that condition, and the finally result comes into. Okay, then we have the switch expression, the value which is going to be compared with the case constant, and then the statement is going to be work, else the default statement. Now. Now this is a program, a very simple program. What is going to be happen in this particular program? So we have declared a character. The name, the value which has been assigned to the character is B, and then we have and the value B is going to be passed to the switch. Okay, and then we have the case A, B, C, D, and D and F, and the value which is in which value which is going to be passed is B, and the value is B is compared with that particular case, and then the value is going to be print. Okay, so the value which compares with that particular case is going to be print. But if you see in this particular case, whenever there is a case B, we have not print anything. Little bit different program from what we have already done. The value which is given inside the case B is not going to be showed. Okay, there is nothing to be print when we are nothing going to be print when we are discussing about the case B. So what happened? Whenever we come out, then no, it matches and it shows nothing. And then the last we have written your grade is this grade, and in grade we have B, so it shows your grade is B.